just a lovely message from the lovely Mr. Gray and his wife and the lovely little Amber. That's Mike, one of my dearest friends, the lovely Barb. And little Amber, how are you, darlings? I hope you can hear me over there. I hope you can see me too. So I'm having a little wave to you. Do you like the frock? It's gorgeous, isn't it? Now, let's have another little quick word with Mr. Lavers here. So what was this about, triplets?
Yes, well, as you know, I'm the father of five.
Good heavens above.
Yes. Two boys and three girls. They arrived at the same moment, you see, so that's why they are triplets.
Oh, he's got it on his iPad, look.
Oh, yes, I've got the wonderful feed on our iPad right now. Look at that.
Oh, God, I can see myself all over the place. Yes, yes. Thank God it's in widescreen.
Yes. Didn't they invent a special lens for you once? It's not like Todd AO, it was Mark AO, I think.
With sensor around. Was it sensor around as well? Because we've got terrible wind.
Yeah.
Yes.
Then no change there, then.
You're not getting out of this triplet thing. What happened about these triplets, then?
I can't tell the real story, can I?
Of course you can tell the real story. Go on. Of course you
can.
I think
that's...
We'll do the clean version.
All right. Okay. Well, we were living in Chatham at the time. We had a lovely three up, two down in Chatham.
Sydney Road.
And we had a lodger. A lodger. Very, very similar to Auntie Mark, who used to sort of keep us entertained and everything. Well, then one weekend, some friends of my wife came down and they stayed and they had a little baby. And we didn't know they were coming, so they sort of squeezed into this little house. In the morning, in runs to our bedroom, my wife's and I, my bedroom, a screaming Auntie Mark saying, "Well, that baby has been bouncing on my nether regions for a number of hours."
Very painful it was.
Absolutely fed up with it. And he suddenly realised, after ranting on for about 15 minutes, he turns around, he says, oh, am I disturbing you? Because yes, we were at it.
You were in what was known as reflected glory.
We were in, yes, it was absolutely in flagrante delicto. You can be rude if you can know Latin, which is brilliant.
If that's what you call it.
So all you have to say is in Latin. Yes, we were caught in flagrante delicto, and unfortunately, because we were caught and we couldn't move, that's why we had triplets.
And I wasn't blamed for it because they're the three... Well, at the time, but they're the three most gorgeous girls, aren't they? We've got Kira, Andrea and Fanula.
Yes, indeed.
And hopefully they're listening in tonight. But I think they're all working, aren't they?
Yeah, well, I know Kira's coming back from a seminar, which I was talking at, actually, on yesterday. And she's been working today with her brother, who's also been doing the seminar.
All right. And what cinema is that? Cinema. I can't get the words out.
Yes.
Shall I start again? Do you know, this must be to do with this lager.
Yes, well, it says it's value, lager.
Of course it's
Can we tell Dabs the camera?
Yeah, go and have a Varda. Have a look at this, then. This is value lager. You get four of those. Yeah, guess what, Paul?
What?
Four of those, 92 pence.
That was a pound shop, was it?
No, it is... Well, I won't mention it. It's a little Scottish supermarket that's suddenly moved down to St James's Street.
Oh, yeah.
In Brighton. And it's fabulous. You ought to see the size of their hocks. They're fantastic at £1.99.
Didn't he play Doctor Who at one point, or thought he was Doctor Who?
Well, Morrison.
Yeah, David Morrison, wasn't he?
Oh, yeah, Morrison. He was a couple of years ago. He played the other Doctor.
No.
Or the new Doctor. The old Doctor
I'm
or the other Doctor.
Oh, come on, keep
Which
up.
Which Doctor?
I'm talking about David Morrissey, in fact. It was a joke.
Oh, is
David
it?
David Morrissey.
That's a joke, is it? Right, okay then.
Oh.
But if that's the way the jokes are going tonight, you're going to be bored to tears, loves,
Lord.
I tell you. We'll try our level best anyway. So what we've got coming up here, this is one for you, Paul, I think.
Oh,
what's
I
it called?
This. You've got to be perfect. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Well, don't look at the picture then.
Life is too short to play silly games. I've promised myself I won't do that again. It's got to be. To be
so foolish. They make such mistakes. They're much too eager to give their love away. Well, I have been foolish too many times. Now I'm determined I'm gonna get.
Did you enjoy that, Paul?
Loved it.
I saw you wibbling your bits about. Yes.
Oh, yes.
Somebody wants to have a bit of a close-up of us, so the camera's really? Coming over here.
What on earth is wrong with them?
I don't know. I mean, honestly, what on really, it's a disgrace.
Can
really.
They be thinking of?
Look at all his cables. He's getting his legs out now. Have a charge at that lot. Christ almighty.
We love a bit of that, don't
yes.
we?
Yes. Pull them down, that's all it. Right. Pull them down. He's getting them down. So we're coming a bit closer now. So can, hopefully you can see us both. There's Hi. The lovely Mr. Paul Lavers.
Hello, how are you?
You may recognise him from the telly.
You may know me from such greats as the Solferino ad.
Oh, yes. And if I remember rightly, a long time ago, yeah. and we're going back, you know, this was in black and white, with the Dear Ladies. Do you remember?
Hinge and Bracket. It's not black and white.
Which one were you?
When Hinge and Bracket, we filmed it. Funnily enough, it's an amazing story, actually, because I was on the wonderful city sightseeing bus the other day.
Oh, yes.
And who
My
should
old
be,
tram.
Who should be there but a lovely lady who runs a costumier down here.
That's where I got my bone of threads from. Lovely Jackie Cryer from Masquerade.
Lovely Jackie. And she said, I know you. I said, do you? And I said, well, did you do the costumes for Doctor Who? She said, no. I said, did you do the costumes for Mel Flanders? She said, no. And went through a whole load of range. And then she said, you did a commercial, didn't you, with Hinge and Brackets? I said, good grief, yes, that was years ago. That was in 1982.
Yeah, and it was Enver Cream, wasn't it?
It was. It was the introduction of pale Enver Cream. And funnily enough, my wife Erin found it on the internet, on YouTube, and I've now got it.
So you can actually, everyone, you can go on the YouTube and look at Paul a million years ago with Hinge and Bracket doing Enver Cream. Oh, he's got his iPad
in
out
fact,
again. He's getting his YouTube up.
Fact,
have a bard at this slot.
I can find it for you. Cause
it's a very, very big phone, that is, isn't it?
Yeah,
oh, I've been asked to come have a look at something. Hold on, what's all going on there? You carry on there. What's
try
there?
Putting this up to your ear. Now, this is the... I'm not doing a commercial for them. Well, I am, actually.
We'll never guess, Bill. We've had a message, Paul.
What's that?
That lovely Mr. Lavers in his... Oh, not Lavers. Sure, that's him. That's that Kevin Davis. Kevin John Davis. Lovely Liam and Elaine, who I've known for...
Almost as long as you've known me.
Since 1977. Yeah. And we met... on at a Doctor Who convention back there with Tom Baker and John Pertwee and all that sort of thing. And hello to Elaine and Kevin and Liam. I hope you can see us. I mean, I'm sorry, it's all in this close-up. Here's a quick one for you, look. Shocking, isn't it? Absolutely shocking. But I must say, my wig's beautiful. This is also from the lovely Jackie Cryer, who obviously dressed Mr. Lavers in a similar outfit. You weren't a dear lady. Oh, look, he's got it up. Look, he's got it up. Oh, hello, he nearly dropped it then. Look, look. Can you see that?
That's either Dame Hilda or Dr. Brackett.
The one with the very high-pitched voice. The one who played the piano was Evadne Hinge, and that's Dame Hilda.
If you want to go and see it later after the show.
Yeah.
You can go and see it on www.paullavers.com and hit the showreel button and go almost down to the end, and you'll see Hinge and Brackett.
Right down the end. You can understand why it's right down the end,
because it's so old. But it is in colour.
Well, I'm surprised. I think with the technology these days, Paul, you've colourised it, because I'm sure it was done on 405 line, and it was done sort of in the days of, you know...
It was 1982, and we did it at the...
Rediffusion, was it?
Richmond Theatre.
At the Richmond Theatre?
Yeah, beautiful.
Oh. Well, on that, I'm going to open my lager.
No.
Oh, that's better. Yeah, it's better out than in. So, so go and look at YouTube, yes, because it's a lovely thing. And, of course, we're mentioning a lot of Doctor Who, which we have a lot of involvement with, and it's one of the reasons I met the lovely Paul Inair and his lovely wife. We're going to talk about it a little bit later on. Dinov, go back. Look at that. Mm. Look at that. It's so old. It's in silent.
He's looking at my website. That's black and white.
That is black and white. I think you had your face done there, didn't you? Yeah. Oh, that's wonderful. What's that there?
This is... Funnily enough, I just received an email from YouTube itself. One of the promos I did when I was back at Ideal World was for a French week. We were doing a French week where we were selling French goods. And so one of the promo...
I like a bit of French.
So one of the promo producers came up with this idea of me being a French aristocrat whose head had been chopped off. And whilst my head was in the basket...
I've seen that.
Whilst my head was in the basket, I was promoing, saying all these wonderful things are coming up. In actual fact, the story behind that is, after being shown on Ideal World for a day, we had one complaint... And the company took it off air.
But you've got it.
It's fun. But so, now it's been watched by 15,000 people on YouTube.
And a French aristocrat, which... what was your handle? Did you have a handle, or was it just...
No, I got down on the floor by myself. I didn't need a handle in those days.
Oh, right. Oh, I say, you are too much, you are, aren't you?
Oh, yes.
Right, now, what we got next? What we got coming up here? What we got then, Sally?
I love it. Sheena Easton, do you remember?
She came
to fame with Big Time.
Big Time with Esther Anson, wasn't it?
Was it, yeah.
Yeah, for BBC.
Love it.
Yes, and also did one of those Bond themes.
All together now.
For Your Eyes Only, it was called.
Time.
Oh, I'll be back in. So, sorry about that. I'm using Sally's lipstick because it's so delicious. Hold on, where's my bins gone?
Cans.
Oh, my cans, the bins, the cans. Oh, I don't know. Oh, I'm back on here. Look,
bins, you used to say that years ago. Bins.
Yes, yes, when we worked in television.
Yes.
Yes, yes. I always call bins and I always get it wrong, like a lot of things. Right, now, we're going to have a little chat about your... the big boss upstairs wants a bit of music in the background, so he's going to give
us... To drown us out.
Yeah,
basically,
basically drown us out, because I think you're going to get a bit of lift music occasional, so if you want us to actually dance to it...
I could probably do with a bit of lift music, to be honest.
Well, I need a bit of a lift, yes.
Yeah.
And I don't mean facially. Now, at the moment, your lovely wife, who I've known for another million years...
She'll thank you for that as well.
Yes. Who came to fame as an actress way back when one of her first ever films she was made was The Tales of Beatrix Potter, which was the film, which was the ballet people, wasn't it?
The Royal Ballet. The ballet people.
Well, I don't know.
Maybe the Royal Ballet.
Was it the Royal Ballet?
Oh, Wayne, what's
Wayne,
his name?
Little One,
yes,
Sleep.
He was in it.
Yeah.
Wayne Sleep.
Well,
was
she
it.
Wasn't dancing in it, you'd be glad to know, because she actually played Beatrix Potter.
And what do you mean by that? She was trained as a dancer, you know.
She wanted to be a dancer. But she wasn't prancing about in the film.
No, she
was. She was actually Beatrix Potter, wasn't
she?
She was. Yes.
She was.
And after that, she was also in a film which the lovely David Essex was in called That'll Be the Day.
That'll Be the Day.
Yeah, and she was playing a teenager in that, wasn't she? I don't know what she was doing.
She was. She was playing on the... They filmed it on the Isle of Wight. One of the stories that Erin tells is that when she was... She was only about 15, 16. And she went into a hotel in... where was it? Would it be Cowes or somewhere like that on the Isle of Wight? And going to her room, she sprawled out in the corridor was Keith Moon.
Well, that's the prize there.
All he was dressed in was a candlewick bed sheet.
Oh, so no knickers then.
And he said, "Come into my room." And she said, I'm a professional actress," and swanned into her room.
Yeah,
Changed, eh?
No, well,
hasn't changed.
Yeah, hence triplets.
Oh.
The other thing is that she was very well known for, until we go on to her current project, is that she was the star of the first few series of the BBC television series, or I think one of the first soapers, the Pre of Casualty in Holby City, Angels.
That's right, and she played the lovable Irish nurse.
Was it Maureen Monaghan?
Maureen Monaghan, yes.
See, that's a memory, isn't it?
God bless you, sir.
And that was in colour, wasn't it?
Yes, it was in colour.
It was in colour. Of course
it was in colour.
Yes, yes. And tell us what she's doing now, because she's now treading the boards.
She's doing a fabulous play with some amazing people. And it all happened very quickly. We were at home one night. I took a phone call. And it was from a friend of ours, a guy called Giles Watling. And people, if you remember Jack Watling.
Jack Watling, yeah.
Giles is his son.
Deborah Watling's the daughter.
And absolutely. And and Giles rang up and he said, Where's Erin? Could you come and take over from one of our actresses who's dropped out of the show? And I said, well, I'm sure she would. Let me just do it. And Erin, of course, said yes. And he said, right, this was a Wednesday night. She had to take over and go on in the show on Friday night. And it's a large part. It's a big part in the first act. And so she learnt it. She got in there, did it, and is doing it brilliantly and is on the road as we speak.
Where's she at the moment, then?
She's in... Last night in Shrewsbury. Well, what she's doing now on... What day is today?
Sunday.
Oh, no, she's doing nothing today.
We've got you some music.
Oh, we're having a bit of music in the background.
She's not... Oh, hello. Christ. Someone's knocking on the door.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, beautiful.
Someone's knocking on the door. Who is that?
Look.
Come in.
Hello.
Come in.
That's a bit sort of Jason King-ish, isn't it? So she's resting today because they always have the Sunday off, don't they?
Not always these days. Certainly not in the West End. However, she is. She's resting. And then tomorrow she's going down to Wolverhampton.
Oh.
Wolverhampton.
And how's business been for the lovely
been
troop of
brilliantly.
Players?
Brilliant. It's been absolutely fabulous. In the cast is Sandra Dickinson.
Oh, yes. Married to Peter Davison many years ago.
And the funny thing is, when I say Sandra Dickinson, most people go, hello, how are you? I'm Sandra Dickinson. She doesn't play it in that voice at all. She plays it with a very lovely voice like that. She's amazing. I really surprised. When she came on stage, I thought, good grief, that can't be Sandra Dickinson.
Well, she played, yeah, if I remember right, she played Trillian in The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy
TV
series.
She did, but it was still with a voice like that.
And it was in that sort of... her American
also,
accent.
There is one of the legends of the theatre and film, of course, Victor Spinetti.
Oh, my goodness me.
Victor
yeah.
Spinetti, who's over 80.
Yes, yes.
And is still amazing. He was in all the Beatles films.
That's right.
He's done so much. And he is just a joy because he's got so many stories. He's fantastic. Also in the cast is... there's a lovely lady, Michelle, who was in The Royal... And there's Chloe, who is in Coronation Street. And who have I forgotten? Oh, who have I forgotten? Norman Pace of Halen Pace.
Halen Pace, yes. And I knew his brother.
Who? Off the Pace.
Off the Pace, yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
I bet you wish I hadn't done that now. But never mind. But they're doing incredible business.
Yeah.
Incredible business. And it's a funny play.
I know. What's it called?
Murdered to Death. Which is probably what you'll be done after the show.
Or no, yourself, sir.
Yeah.
Now, tell us, I think the closest Erin's going to be down here is going to be in Worthing, isn't
Worthing
it?
Worthing in August.
August.
And I'm desperately trying to find the actual dates, but I can't find it in the internet. That's ridiculous, isn't it?
Well, what we'll do, we'll have a look at that and we can give her a bit of a plug later. So it's Murder to Death at hopefully the Connaught Theatre in...
Yeah, I believe it is. I actually think I can remember a website where it would have it all up there.
Yeah.
But
have a look at Erin's website. Have a look at Erin's Facebook.
Yeah. Oh, well, yes, that's true.
Yeah, should be on there.
Oh, that's right. Oh, you're clever.
Yeah, well, I try my best.
Oh, iPad, thank you. Just go to...
Oh, he's still going about this iPad.
To Facebook.
Our engineer, Jay, is having conniptions over this iPad. I don't think he's ever seen one.
That is wonderful,
yeah.
I tell you.
Look at that, look at that. The technology in one hand.
You've got some messages here, aren't you?
I've got some messages. Hold on a moment. Let's have a look what we've got here. You just turn that. I can't
really
see.
Get any more
purchases. Yeah, I never get any purchases at all,
that's
dear. Now, somebody did ask me a moment about the Polari. Of course, you know, the Bonapalones and all that. Yes, that all comes from the old days of Round the Horn and all that. You remember Kenneth Williams and Hugh Paddock
yes.
and the lovely Kenneth Horn. And that was a series that was on the radio and which actually nearly shut all the theatres because everyone went home to listen to Round the Horn, which, of course, in those days, in the 60s, was broadcast live. So that is where Polari comes from. And all you Bona Palones and Omis, it's Bona Tavada, your Dolly Odd Eeks over there. And it's Bona Tavada, my friend's Dolly Odd Eek here.
You leave my eek alone, mate.
Yes. I mean, you've got lovely lallies too, haven't you?
Oh, I haven't seen me lallies for years.
Oh, thews like oaks and whopping great lallies, I understand. Is that correct?
What
else have we got here?
Rumor.
Somebody else has... Hold on, I've never had to look down because you can't get purchase.
What's this saying?
Yes.
Mmm. So ladylike with the lippy, yes. Well, it's Sally's lippy, actually.
Who's that there? I can't read that. Oh, John, my glasses need adjusting. Justin? Is it Justin?
Just in time.
Auntie Mark, love Michelle TP.
Do you want me to read them out?
Yeah, would you read them out, Sally? Because I can't.
Hang on, where are you?
I am...
Look, Fab Auntie Mark, Michelle TP, Ian's wife.
Oh, thank you, Michelle. Yes, that's our friend Ian Taylor Page. Yes, who you were listening to earlier with the lovely Jay, who's sorting out my sounds. Yes. What else have we got down there, Sally?
Well, I don't know. We've got bootleg. I don't know who that is. So,
ladylike
with a lippy, LOL. I think
you're
beautiful.
Somebody's just talking about my videotape running out. My videotape never runs out, darling.
Wasn't that Rolf Harris?
According to the screen graphics.
My video has run out.
It has run out.
Oh, it says tape end.
It doesn't matter.
Oh, it doesn't matter.
Can I get Worthing?
All right, now we're back to Worthing.
Worthing.
Now. So
when
are we on Worthing?
Week commencing the 9th. It starts on Tuesday, the 9th of August, and it goes through to the Saturday at the Connaught Theatre, Worthing.
Yes, 9th of August is also my mum's birthday, would you believe?
Love her.
And this year she'll be 83.
Oh, love. Are you going to let her out of the box this time?
Yes, I will, darling. She's a lovely old duck. She really is.
She'll love her. Can I just... Michelle Hardwick. Do you remember... In if you watch The Royal, Michelle's in that. She's lovely. And Chloe Newsom was...
Always having to think now.
Who was she in Coronation Street? She was... Oh, she was someone's daughter. I think she was... Who's the woman behind the bar?
Bette Lynch.
No, dear, not that far back. She's only a young girl. Bette Lynch.
Do you know, they
said she's going to come back. Bette Lynch.
Do you know? I wouldn't be surprised. She'd been backwards and forwards quite a few times.
Yes, though, she? I bet she has.
Bette Lynch, yeah.
So I've heard.
Yeah, the lovely Julie Goodyear.
Yes.
Mm. Right, what's the next song we've got?
Who's sailing her?
Yeah, but no, he hasn't got a clue now. So what's the next song we've got?
Pointer Sisters.
Oh, it's the Pointer Sisters. Oh, I like this. It's the Pointer Sisters.
Rude to point.
Me.
I'm back again.
I'm back again.
No, they've had a bit
like
of a
coming in from somewhere.
Yeah, I'm back. I've got my bins on. No, they're not my bins, my cans. Mm. Now, they moved this down so I can see it because I was stretching it across and I occasionally do like a stretch, if you know what I mean. But unfortunately at the moment I couldn't read this and I do need to get some proper glasses because I can't really read that. Brighton Babe is saying to me, hi, auntie. Well, hi, Brighton Babe. And it's lovely to have your little messages from me. There's a lovely person here. There's one for you there, Paul, who wants an iPad.
Yes.
Yes.
Well, I am taking orders.
Yes, and yes, and I'm sure that you're not going to give yours away, are you?
I doubt it.
No. You got that for your birthday.